Hello friends, thanks for visiting our channel again. We'll begin this new episode with an update on how SpaceX beat Boeing to become NASA's top for-profit supplier. Data provided by Aviation Week reporter IRENE KLOTZ reveals that SpaceX has supplanted every other significant U.S. aerospace company to become the space agency's largest for-profit vendor 14 years after securing its first significant NASA contract. Although SpaceX's ascent up to those ranks has been difficult and far from guaranteed, the business now offers NASA a variety of reasonably affordable spaceflight services. In fiscal year 2022, SpaceX received a record payment of $2.04 billion for these services. Only one other organization is ranked higher on NASA's list of FY 2022 vendors, the California Institute of Technology, Caltech, a nonprofit that houses the entire Jet Propulsion Laboratory, JPL. And got $2.68 billion during the same time. Lockheed Martin finishes with $1.34 billion and Boeing with $1.72 billion. NASA and SpaceX began working together in December 2008 after NASA awarded SpaceX a $1.5 billion contract to create the initial Cargo Dragon spacecraft and Falcon 9 rocket to transport cargo to the International Space Station, ISS. Elon Musk, the company's creator and CEO, is famous for having claimed on an episode of 60 Minutes that SpaceX was somewhat spared from bankruptcy and dissolution by NASA's contract. Due to the influx of funds, SpaceX was able to successfully debut Falcon 9 in June 2010, and in October 2012, the Commercial Resupply Services (CRS) program, run by NASA, began accepting operational cargo deliveries to the International Space Station. The CRS partnership between NASA and SpaceX has achieved a complete success, barring two minor Falcon 9 failures on CRS-1 in 2012 and CRS-7 in 2015. Supply Dragon's 26th successful ISS cargo delivery in 10 years is expected to occur on CRS-26, which SpaceX will launch in a few weeks. SpaceX received a final payment from NASA of $3.04 billion for completing the first 20 CRS missions. NASA will probably spend an additional $3.5 billion on the CRS-2 contract, which SpaceX recently signed and started in January 2021. It has 15 missions contracted. An estimated $700 million in annual revenue is generated by the three CRS missions that SpaceX launches on average each year. NASA received two Cargo Dragon missions from SpaceX in FY 2022. Crew Dragon is SpaceX's second-largest income source from NASA. In order to replace the function the Space Shuttle and Russian Soyuz spacecraft filled from the year 2000 to 2020, NASA signed a contract with SpaceX and Boeing in 2014 to independently develop spacecraft capable of carrying passengers to and from the International Space Station. The first crewed test flight of Crew Dragon took place in May 2020. After its first unmanned orbital test flight was completed in March 2019. Launches for operational use started in November 2020. Contrary to expectations, and three full years after SpaceX, Boeing's Starliner crew capsule successfully performed its maiden unmanned test flight in May 2022. The first operational launch of an astronaut aboard Starliner is currently planned for Q3 2023 at the earliest, with the first crewed test flight taking place no sooner than February 2023. Every NASA astronaut, except one, has been launched by SpaceX since late 2020 and will continue to do so through at least 2023 as a result of Boeing's appalling performance, in contrast to the Commercial Crew Program's initial expectation that SpaceX and Boeing would launch once each annually. SpaceX is now available for NASA's two Crew Dragon missions per year. In 2022, NASA made the unusual decision to buy 8 further Crew Dragon missions while acquiring 0 additional Starliner launches. In contrast to Boeing, who NASA will pay $5.1 billion to launch just 6 operating Starliner rockets, SpaceX has an agreement to carry out 14 operational Crew Dragon missions for NASA through 2030 for a cost of $4.93 billion. SpaceX will bill NASA around $220 million for each of its first six operational missions. From Crew 7 to Crew 14, SpaceX will bill between $290 million and $300 million for each trip. For NASA in FY 2022, SpaceX successfully conducted two Crew Dragon launches. Along with launching Dragons for NASA, SpaceX also primarily relies on its Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets to send a variety of scientific missions into orbit. Since 2010, SpaceX has received over $1 billion from NASA's Launch Services Program (LSP) to execute six launches, each valued around $400 million, and get ready for at least nine more. Between November 2022 and June 2026, SpaceX is slated to conduct nine more LSP launches, which would run NASA about $1.4 billion. Over $1 billion of that $1.4 billion will be spent on five of those missions, which will use SpaceX's bigger Falcon Heavy rocket. The final significant line item on NASA's SpaceX expenses is dedicated to Starship. NASA awarded SpaceX a Human Landing System (HLS) contract in April 2021 for $2.9 billion, roughly $3 billion when prior funding's factored in. The goal of the project is to create a moon landing system based on the Starship that can carry astronauts to and from the lunar surface. NASA has given SpaceX $1.26 billion since 2020 for its HLS-related work. Let's wrap up with an update where SpaceX will launch the first asteroid orbiter and Europe's upcoming Deep Space Telescope. At an Astrophysics Advisory Committee meeting on October 17th, a NASA representative reported that the European Satellite Agency (ESA) had started exploring options and investigating the viability of launching the Euclid Near-Infrared Space Observatory on SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket. When it comes to rocket launch services, the European Union, and indirectly the ESA, are infamously exclusive and partisan. The success of the European Space Agency and the French business Arianespace in the 1980s, 90s, and 2000s on the world market for commercial launches, a position that was battled for and eventually appeared to be taken for granted by all parties, was largely responsible for the mindset. For the first time in more than 15 years, Arianespace found itself facing a truly dangerous opponent when that golden age crashed head-on against the brick wall built by SpaceX in the middle of the 2010s. Hera was slated to be one of the first payloads launched by Ariane 64 rocket using the brand new Asterisk kickstage that Arianespace was developing. Hera would have considerably boosted its chances of missing its 17-day October 2024 window if it had continued with the first three-stage Ariane 6 following the most recent delay. Hera would have backup possibilities to extend the mission's cruise phase travel time from 2 years to more than 5 years if she missed that brief opening in 2025 or 2026 due to the orbital mechanics of the system. The main goal of the 290 million euro Hera mission is to circle the moon Dimorphos near the near-Earth asteroid Didymos and explore a recent impact crater there. Since it was purposely made when NASA's DART mission collided with the asteroid moon last month, that crater's brand new. It seems appropriate that SpaceX flew DART to Dimorphos on a Falcon 9 rocket and will now launch Hera shortly afterward, maybe in October 2024. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.